Lieutenant, your journal came.
Radar, you have anything for me?
Do I?
Hi, Radar.
Do I have a...
Did I get a letter?
Oh, no, I don't think so. But if I may say, that's a very nice towel you're wearing, Lieutenant. Look at this, you dodo. You stand here talking to yourself. Jerk.
Mail call.
Sensational. Anything in a pale blue envelope smells as though it was written by a girl in a summer dress, a spray of lilac at her elbow.
You got a letter from your congressman that the mail truck threw into Colonel Potter's corral by mistake.
I think I'll pass.
I'll take anything from my family, no matter how it smells. It
smells like crayons.
Sure it's not from my congressman?
Hey, Radar. What's up? You look down.
Well, to tell you the truth, can I talk to you guys?
To tell you the truth, why not?
Pull up a bunk.
Hey, thanks. Well, I'm very concerned about something which concerns my life here.
What's the trouble, Andy?
Well, I don't think that this place is turning out to be that great an experience for me. I mean, I work under terrible pressures, and there's lots of death and destruction and stuff, but other than that, I don't think I'm getting much out of it.
I knew there was something wrong with this place.
I mean, the Army's supposed to... It's supposed to make a man out of you, isn't it?
Well, it depends which sex you are to start with. I mean, you have to meet them halfway.
Well, I'm just basically the same person that I was that I came in with.
You think you could have run an outfit this big before you came over here?
Well, that's just being a good clerk.
What would you rather be?
Okay, now listen. This is just, it's just talk.
Yeah, yeah,
you know,
yeah.
I mean, it's just sort of thinking out loud.
Yeah, yeah.
What do you want to be?
Oh, a hot lover. Or even a cold one. I don't care.
What makes you think the Army can help you with that?
When my Uncle Ed came home from World War I, his mother could tell by the look in his eyes that he hadn't been a good boy in France. She cried for 3 days. I just know when I go home, my mother's going to take one look at me and chuckle for a week.
Wait, are you working yourself into a froth over nothing?
Oh, nothing, huh?
Look, it's not such a big deal. Write yourself a weekend pass, borrow a Jeep, and go down to the Pink Pagoda in Seoul. Find some nice lady who reminds you of your father and let nature take its course.
You mean go to the Pink Pagoda in Seoul, make friends with a lady, and let nature take its course?
Well, that's another way of putting it, yes.
Hey, maybe you're not cut out for a life of depravity. Stick to sniffing letters.
Yeah, but I'm the only one that's going to leave this place younger than I was when I came in.
So go to Seoul. Get it over with.
You mean actually go to Seoul and, you know...
A little you-know never hurt anybody. Some of our greatest presidents did you-know.
So let him wait till he's elected. Don't rush him.
Who's rushing him? He's over 12.
Radar, relax. When the time is right, you'll go.
Your glasses are fogging. Go.
Okay. Okay, I will. Next week.
Now.
Okay. Okay. Now. You know something? I feel different already. I think I'm getting a fever.